ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الكلام كلام الله وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وبعد Indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in revealing to us His Quran and in revealing to us this Kitab al-Azim has blessed us with that which is filled with hikam and much wisdoms for those who reflect. And Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has mentioned in His Kitab a number of qisas and a number of stories. All of those stories not being for plain amusement or not being for the sake of merely quoting and mentioning stories or asatir al-awwaleen, tales of those who came before. Rather, they were stories, ikhwan, that were filled with hikam for those who reflect. As Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has said, نَحْنُ نَقُصُّ عَلَيْكَ أَحْسَنُ الْقَصَصِ بِمَا أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ. That indeed we will reveal to you and we will narrate to you the best of qasas, the best of stories in the revelation of this Qur'an, in that we have revealed to you this Qur'an. And Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala informs us, ayyuhal ikhwa, of a story that the shabab al-salafi, that the salafi youth, those who walk the way of Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah, Ahlul Athar, Ahlul Hadith, can reflect upon. Particularly those living in a place like this place, Britannia, or the likes of America, and other than that from the dual of the Kuffar. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala has informed us of a group of youth, a group of youth who were upon right guidance, a group of youth who were in essence Salafiyun, a group of youth following the way of the Anbiya that came before them, clinging to Tawheed, clinging to the Sunnah of their Messenger, and upon the way and the path of the righteous. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has said, أَمْ حَسِبْتَ أَنَّ أَصْحَابَ الْكَهْفِ وَالرَّقِيمِ كَانُوا مِنْ آيَاتِنَا عَجَبًا. Will you believe, or do you believe, that the companions of the cave and the inscriptions were مِنْ آيَاتِنَا عَجَبًا, were a wonder from amongst our signs, from our signs? Indeed that is the case, that the Ashab al-Kahf was a wonder from amongst the wonders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and was a sign from amongst the signs of Allah. إِذْ أَوَى الْفِتْيَةُ إِلَى الْكَهْفِ فَقَالُوا رَبُّنَا آتِنَا مِنْ لَدُنْكَ رَحْمَةً وَهَيِّئْنَا مِنْ أَمْرِنَا رَشَدًا. If they, or the time when they retreated to the cave, when they retreated to the cave, saying, "Oh our Lord, give us from yourselves rahmah, give us from yourself rahmah and mercy, and make for us from yourself ar-rushd, guidance. Bless us and grant us mercy and guide us." And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likewise mentions, نَحْنُ نَقُصُّ عَلَيْكَ نَبَاهُمْ بِالْحَقِّ إِنَّهُمْ فِتْيَةٌ آمَنُوا بِرَبِّهِمْ. That indeed we will narrate to you and inform you of their story in truth. إِنَّهُمْ فِتْيَةٌ آمَنُوا بِرَبِّهِمْ. Indeed they were a group of youth who believed in their Lord. وَزِدْنَاهُمْ هُدًى. And we increased them in that guidance. وَرَبَطْنَا عَلَى قُلُوبِهِمْ إِذْ قَامُوا فَقَالُوا رَبَّنَا رَبُّنَا رَبُّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. And we made their hearts firm. يعني that we gave them certainty and yaqeen when they said, "Our Lord, the Lord of the heavens and the earth, we will not call upon anyone other than Him." لَقَدْ قُلْنَا إِذًا شَطَطًا. Indeed, if we would do that, if we call upon other than Allah, then we would have committed indeed, and we would have said something extreme and something great. So Allah informed us of them. هَؤُلَاءِ قَوْمُنَا. Say, هَؤُلَاءِ قَوْمُنَا اتَّخَذُوا مِن دُونِهِ إِلَهَا. That indeed, our people, they have taken a god, they have taken a deity other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَوْ لَا يَأْتُونَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِسُلْطَانٍ بَيِّنٍ. Why have they not come to us and brought a sultanin bayin, some authority, something from a proof for the shirk that they have committed? And there is no doubt that they are not able to do that. So they continued and retreated to the cave, fleeing with their tawheed, fleeing with that which they were upon from following the guidance of the messenger that came before them and the way of the messengers, seeking to worship Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. So Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala informs us of their case and informs us that as a sign He let them to go to sleep. He left them to go to sleep for a number of years. As Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has informed us, 300 years was dadu tis'a. 300 years and add to that 9. And Ahlul Ilm have mentioned concerning the mention of those years. Why did Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala mention add to that 9? They mentioned because the years that they were working with were solar years. And for every 100 solar year, there are 103 lunar years. So for this ummah to be precise in regards to their calculation of exactly how many years they dwelled in the cave, Zadu was Dadu Tis'a. We must increase another 9 years, as Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala informs us in the Quran. So Allah left them to sleep for 309 years, ikhwan. Allah mentioned concerning the state of the affair, وَتَرَى الشَّمْسَ إِذَا طَلَعَتْ تَزَاوَرُ أَنْ كَهْفِهِمْ ذات اليمين. And you will see the sun when it rises, that it inclines away from their cave to the right. وَإِذَا غَرَبَتْ تَقْرُصُهُمْ ذات الشِّمَالِ وَهُمْ فِي فَجْوَةٍ مِنْهُ. And when the sun sets, it sets towards the left. Meanwhile, they are in a fajwa, in a crevice in the cave. ذَلِكَ مِنْ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ. That indeed that is from the signs of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Allah likewise informs us concerning them, تَحْسَبُهُمْ أَيْقَاذًا وَهُمْ رُقُودٍ, that you will believe that they were awake, meanwhile they were asleep. وَنُقَلِّبُهُمْ ذَاتَ الْيَمِينِ وَذَاتَ الشِّمَالِ, and we will turn them and we turn them to the left and to the right while they were asleep, their eyes being open. And Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala throughout the 309 years turning them to the left and turning them to the right. And some of Ahlul Ilm have mentioned that the reason for that was for the protection of their bodies and for the protection of their eyes, and that that was better in stopping them from fortifying, and their bodies fortifying in a particular manner. وَنُقَلِّبُهُمْ ذَاتَ الْيَمِينِ وَذَاتَ الشِّمَالِ وَكَلْبُهُمْ بَاسِتٌ ذِرَاعَيْهِ فِي الْوَصِيدِ, and that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala mentions, and their kelb, their dove, has its arms outstretched in the mouth of the cave. And if you were to see them, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala said, لَوَلَّيْتَ مِنْهُمْ فِرَارًا, you would have fled from them. وَلَمُلِئْتَ مِنْهُمْ رُعْبًا, you would have fled from them. وَلَمُلِئْتَ مِنْهُمْ رُعْبًا, and you would have been filled with fear. So Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala informs us concerning them that He left them to sleep for that period in that manner, the like of which if we were to see them, that we would have been frightened from them. You would have believed them to be asleep, awake, meanwhile they were asleep. Then Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala informs us that they awoke, asking each other concerning how long they had slept. Some of them saying to each other, we slept for a day or part of a day. Others from amongst them saying, indeed our Lord knows best how long we slept. So one of them sent another to the city in order to buy something from food, commanding him, وَلْيَتَلَطَّفْ, and that you should go and be careful when you go. وَلَا يُشْعِرَنَّ بِكُمْ أَحَدًا, and you should not let any one of them know and be aware of you. إِنَّهُمْ إِنْ يَظْهَرُوا عَلَيْكُمْ يَرْجُمُوكُمْ, that indeed if they were to be aware of you, they would stone you or they would return you back to your old way. And indeed if that was to happen, you would never be successful. If you return back to the way of shirk and back to the way of kufr and back to the way of those people, ahl al-kufr wa shirk, then indeed you will never be successful. And then Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala mentions that indeed we let the people come aware of them, لِيَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ وَعْدَ اللَّهِ حَقٍ, so that they would know that the promise of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is true. وَأَنَّ السَّاعَةَ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهَا, and that the hour, there is no doubt concerning that. Ahlul Kitab concerning the story differed. And Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala tells us concerning their differing, سَيَقُولُونَ ثَلَاثَةٌ وَرَابِعُهُمْ كَلْبُهُمْ, that they will say that they were three in number, the fourth of them being their dove. وَيَقُولُونَ خَمْسَةٌ وَسَادِسُهُمْ كَلْبُهُمْ رَجْمًا بِالْغَيْبِ, and they will say five, and the sixth of them was their dove, رَجْمًا بِالْغَيْبِ, yani grabbing in the unseen, guessing. وَيَقُولُونَ سَبْعَةٌ وَثَامِنُهُمْ كَلْبُهُمْ, and they will say that they were seven and the eighth of them was their dog. Say, your Lord knows best concerning their number, مَا يَعْلَمُهُمْ إِلَّا قَلِيلٌ. Indeed, they were not known except by a few. So Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala informs us concerning them and concerning their story, and that their story was مِنْ آيَاتِنَا عَجَبًا. And that without doubt, ikhwan, is the case, that their story was an amazing story for those who reflect. Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen wa sallallahu wa sallam wa barik ala nabina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Amma ba'd. Concerning their story, ayyuhal ikhwa, there is no doubt that there are a number of benefits and fawa'id that can be taken from the qissa. The first of those benefits is that without doubt the ashab al-kahf, the companions of the cave, as we mentioned, were a people and were a group of shabab who were salafiyin. A group of shabab who were upon the way of tawheed, concerning themselves with the da'wah to tawheed, concerning themselves with protecting their tawheed, concerning themselves with protecting that which was given to them from the way of their anbiya, the way of their nabi, the messenger that was sent to them and it was relevant to them, protecting their aqeedah. And for that reason, in their desire to protect their aqeedah, they fled, ikhwan, to the hills, fled and took refuge in a cave, protecting themselves from that kufr and from that shirk. And that will indicate to us that which occurred, ikhwan, in the hadith of Hudhayfa radiallahu anhu. The hadith that you're all familiar with, wherein the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked by Hudhayfa concerning this khair, and will there be after this khair any evil? And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, na'am. And informed us when Hudhayfa radiallahu anhu answered and questioned concerning the evil and the good that has taint in it, on both accounts, we find that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed us that that which is the evil, concerning that which he asked about, and likewise the taint that was present in the good, all of that, ayyuhal ikhwa, revolved around callers. All of that revolved around callers. Some of them calling with other than the guidance of the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. Some of them calling to the hellfire. If one answers to them, then they will throw them into the hellfire. But the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam on both accounts responded and informed Hudhayfa that on both accounts, that which is evil that will come after the good, and that which is going to taint that which is good, on both accounts, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed concerning callers. And for that reason, Ahlul Sunnah, Ahlul Hadith, the Salafiyun, likewise warn against the callers. Warn against the callers to Balala. Warn against the callers of misguidance. Warn against Ahlul Bid'ati wa Balalati wa Shirk. Warn protecting that Tawheed, protecting that Aqeedah, and doing as the Ashab al-Kahf did in doing so. Likewise, ayyuhal ikhwa, we have that which will clarify to us the statement of Ahlul Ilm that Al-Bid'ah Barid al-Kufr. That al-bid'ah, an innovation, is that thing which leads to kufr and leads to shirk. That if one was to analyze those nations that came before, you will find, ayyuhal ikhwa, that the beginning of their deviancy and the beginning of their path to kufr and shirk was with the bid'ah. It wasn't that they were a nation upon tawheed and upon following their messenger. Then all of a sudden, they saw that shirk was something nice and something that they should be upon. Rather, it was a gradual process. A process that began with bid'ah, began with that thing that resembled the deen, that resembled the religion, until the shaitan tricked them into believing that that which they were upon from shirk was in actuality deen, almost khair. Likewise, ayuhal ikhwah, from that which can be taken from the story of the Ashab al-Kahf, is the fadl of our Salaf. Is the fadl of our Salaf upon us. Because our Salaf, ikhwan, has clarified to us, and by way of them, we have clarity concerning that which Ahlul Kitab differed concerning. Because indeed Ahlul Kitab differed concerning the number of the Ashabul Kahf. But we have with us in a narration from Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu that was collected by Imam al-Tabari in his tafsir, the statement of Ibn Abbas that clarified to us the exact number of the Ashabul Kahf. That he mentioned concerning the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لا يعلمهم إلا قليل, that no one knows concerning them. After Allah mentioned that they will say the fourth of them being their dog, and five, the sixth of them being their dog. Then Allah mentions no one knows the number of them except for a few. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu mentioned concerning that statement, لا يعلمهم إلا قليل, قال وأنا من القليل كانوا سبعة. He said, and I am from the few. They were seven. So we have that which will clarify to us the father of our Salaf. That which Ahlul Kitab differed concerning was an amr that was wadih and clear for this ummah. Likewise, we have in the story of the Ashab al-Kahf, from fawa'id and from benefits, that which will clarify to us, ayyuhal ikhwa, the importance of this aqeedah and the importance of this tawheed. And that is that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has informed us. And indeed, when we made the people to come aware of them, when we let the people come aware of them, some of Ahlul Ilm have said that was when the individual from amongst them went with a coin, that the people had realized that the coin was an old coin, and therefore became aware of the affair of those people. That Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala mentioned. And likewise, أَعْثَرْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ لِيَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ وَعْدَ اللَّهِ حَقٌّ وَأَنَّ السَّاعَةَ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهَا. And likewise, we made the people to become aware of them, that they should know أَنَّ وَعْدَ اللَّهِ حَقٌّ, that the promise of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is haqq. That which Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has promised is truth. وَأَنَّ السَّاعَةَ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهَا. And that the sa'ah, there is no doubt concerning that. So here Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala informs us that from the reasons, from the major reasons that Allah let them to sleep, that Allah let them to sleep for 309 years, that Allah let the sun deal with their cave in that manner, and Allah let their bodies move and preserve their eyes, was for the purpose of establishing an asl from the usul of the aqeedah of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, the belief in the sa'ah, the belief in the hour. Establishing to us the importance of this aqeedah, establishing to us the importance of that which the ulama of Ahl Sunnah have encouraged the ummah with, and mentioned that it is upon the ummah to turn to that and concentrate upon that and have that firmly established in one's heart, the aqeedah of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, And Allah likewise informs us that the creations of the heavens and the earth, the creations of the heavens and the earth and that which is between that, likewise was for the purpose of establishing some of the points in Aqeedah, some of the issues of Aqeedah. Allahu alladhi khalaqa as-samawati wa min al-sab'a samawat wa min al-ardi mithlahum yatanazzalu al-amra baynahum لتعلموا أن الله على كل شيء قدير وأن الله قد أحاط بكل شيء علما. Allah تبارك وتعالى, who created the seven earths, seven heavens, and earths like unto them, the command of Allah descends between them. لماذا؟ لتعلموا أن الله على كل شيء قدير. So that you may know that Allah is Al-Qadir, that Allah has ability over everything. وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ أَحَاطَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عِلْمًا, and that Allah has encompassed everything in ilm. That you may know that Allah تبارك وتعالى has ability over everything, that Allah is Al-Qadir and Allah is Al-Halim. So that the creations therefore of the heavens and the earth and that which is between them, from the purposes of that, was establishing two of the names of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, Al-Qadir and Al-Halim. Establishing to us, ikhwan, clearly the importance of this aqidah and the importance of al-ilm. Because in both cases Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala mentioned, لِتَعْلَمُوا, that Allah did that, created the heavens and the earth, لِتَعْلَمُوا, that you may know, have ilm. And Allah made the people come aware of the people of the cave. He made the people become aware of them. لِيَعْلَمُوا, so that they may know and have ilm. Both cases indicating to us the fadl and the importance of ilm. So Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala established to us all of those affairs, ikhwan, for the purpose of establishing ilm and establishing aspects of the aqeedah. So there is no doubt, ayyuhal ikhwa, that the fawaid and the benefits that can be taken from that story are many. From that likewise, is that the tawfiq upon a servant is in the hands of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. That Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has said concerning them, إِنَّهُمْ فِتْيَةٌ آمَنُوا بِرَبِّهِمْ وَزِدْنَاهُمْ هُدَى, and we increased them in guidance. Indeed they were a youth who believed in their Lord, and we increased them in guidance. And Allah has said concerning this ummah, and has mentioned to this ummah, وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينَا, that indeed those who strive in our way, that we shall guide them, سُبُلَنَا, that we shall guide them to our path. That Allah has mentioned that the guidance, likewise Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has mentioned, وَالَّذِينَ اهْتَدَوْا زَادَهُمْ هُدَى وَآتَاهُمْ تَقْوَاهُمْ, and those who are guided, and Allah has guided, then He increases them in that guidance and He gives them that their taqwa. So the tawfiq is from Allah, and the tawfiq upon a servant and the guidance upon a servant is in the hands of Allah, and it's upon that servant, ayyuhal ikhwa, to turn to Allah asking Him for the huda, asking Him to protect him from shirk and from tawheed, and from the different types of bid'ah and hizbiyah, and other than that, from the things which misguide a servant and lead him to the path of dalala and lead him to the path of destruction. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يوفقنا وإياكم لما يحبه ويرضاه, وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد, والحمد لله رب العالمين.